Today I want to take a look at how we can go about importing images into Adobe Lightroom. Now, this is a super basic skill. Obviously, if you've used Lightroom for any length of time, you know how to do this. You've done it because you have to do it in order to use Lightroom. But I do want to go through it because I think a lot of people don't fully understand importing and can use the review and can definitely use a little touch up on what they're actually doing when they import photos. Now, before we dive in, I have to first do a little bit of explanation on what importing does, because a lot of people have a little bit of a misunderstanding with how Lightroom's catalog functions and how that all works. First and foremost, when you import pictures into Lightroom, you are not actually taking the images themselves and bringing them into the Lightroom catalog. What I mean by that is somewhere on your computer, there's a file called probably lightroomcatalog.lrcat, or if you've customized that, whatever you've named it, .lrcat. That little file is your Lightroom catalog. And at no point in time does that file actually contain your pictures. That's not the way Lightroom works. Instead, that little file contains the locations of your images. Meaning when you import images into Lightroom, you are teaching the catalog where your photographs live, not actually taking those photographs and putting them into the catalog. The catalog remembers the locations, not the actual images themselves. To really furthermore and hammer home this point, what I mean by that is, if you have your catalog and your photos, and you found those images that you'd imported into Lightroom living somewhere on your hard drive, and you deleted them, they're gone. The catalog doesn't have the images contained within it. If you delete the photos that catalog is referencing, you lose the pictures. So now that that's out of the way, I wanna go ahead and move into how we import. Now, I have a memory card here. I wanna first off start by saying that you can import from a memory card, you can import from an external hard drive, you can import from anywhere. It doesn't have to be a memory card. But in this example, I wanna do the memory card import because I think that's what most of us are gonna do when we import into Lightroom. So I'm gonna plug in the card. Well, notice I have Lightroom running right now, and in a second, it may or may not pop up the import dialog box. Depends on your preferences. Sometimes it happens, sometimes it doesn't. In this case, it's not. So what I'm gonna do is, if I see the import dialog box, great. If it doesn't pop up for you automatically, I'm gonna go down to the lower left-hand corner and hit the import button. Now, that takes us into the import dialog box. Now, in here, there's a few things we need to do. The first thing is we need to tell Lightroom what files we want to import. And that's done by using the upper left-hand corner up here. We can set what's called the source, where we want to import files from. And if we go to this source, we can click up here and we can go to other source. You'll notice it gives you some things like desktop, my pictures, my videos. Usually the images that you want to import are not in one of those three locations, so you'll have to go to other source. And from here, we can choose what images we want to bring in to Lightroom. Now again, bring into Lightroom, using that very roughly here, bringing into Lightroom does not mean that we're actually bringing the images into that catalog file. It just means we're telling the catalog that there's some images that exist, okay? So we can pick our source over here, and you can pick an external hard drive, an internal hard drive, a folder on your computer. You can see this is just a normal file browser on my computer. In this instance, I'm going to choose EOS Digital because that is the memory card that's plugged into my computer. So I'm gonna go ahead and pick on that. I'm gonna hit select. And oh, all of a sudden everything disappeared. Well, that's because we need to turn on this include subfolders checkbox, which says, hey, look inside of that EOS Digital card, and you'll notice that there are some subfolders. I want you to search inside of those subfolders as well, Lightroom, in order to find my photos. So we'll turn that on. That's the first thing. Step number two, we need to tell Lightroom how to deal with our pictures, what to do with our images. Now, this gets a little bit complicated, and for the sake of this video, we're not gonna spend time talking about the advantages and disadvantages of DNG files versus RAW files and all that kind of stuff. For the most part, just think of there being as three main settings here. There's copy, there's move, and there's add. And all three do different things. So let me take one each one in turn. Copy, first of all, will do very simple things. If you have your memory card and you're telling Lightroom to import pictures from the memory card, whatever your destination is, and I personally store my images on an external hard drive, but if you store yours on an internal hard drive, whatever it happens to be, whatever that destination is, if you use the copying option, Lightroom is going to take each image from your memory card, copy it, and take that copy and put it in the destination. So your external hard drive or internal hard drive or wherever you want those images to go. Now, Very important. As it does that, it's also going to teach Lightroom, the catalog, where those images live. So Lightroom will reference those images and remember those images as living wherever your destination is set. Copying leaves them on the card, copies them to a new location. Moving does a move. Instead of them being copied, they're going to move from the memory card to the new location. Now, important thing with moving, I wouldn't really move from a card. I don't really recommend that. In fact, Lightroom actually grays it out. It won't let you pick it. Reason being is if you move from a memory card, if that card dies, then you are losing your backup of the images. Or if your computer dies, you're losing the backup of the images. Copying makes a lot of sense because when the import is done, you've still got the images on the card as well as on the computer. So it's like an instant backup you could think of. Now, obviously when you format the card, that goes away, but that's what other backups are for. Do those, they're good. All right, so moving moves, add. Add is a little bit confusing for some people. Add is gonna do this. It's going to take the images and it's gonna leave them wherever they are. So if you're importing from a card, it's gonna leave them on the card. If you're importing from an internal hard drive location, it'll leave them on the internal hard drive location. It's gonna leave them where they are, but it's gonna teach Lightroom about those photos. So Lightroom would then be referencing the images as living wherever they're currently living. Now, let me walk you through a little example here. If we were to add images from a memory card, and I wanna point out, Lightroom actually won't let us do that. That option is grayed out, which is good. Let's say we add it off of a memory card. Well, if you did that, Lightroom would, the catalog, would remember your images as living on the memory card, which means as soon as you import, you could edit, you could sort, you could organize, you could do all those things that you wanna do, and there would be no issue. But as soon as you unplug the memory card, Lightroom is going to lose all of those photographs because it's expecting to find them on the card. You unplug that card, you format it, all of a sudden Lightroom's catalog can't find those images anymore. And I have had students in the past do that, and it's a really disappointing day because they lose all of their images. So adding is only when you're importing pictures into Lightroom that already live where you want them to live, okay? For a memory card, 100% of the time, I would copy or copy as DNG. And I'll make a video on that in the future, talking about the differences between RAW files and DNG files. So that's number two. Step number one, we choose our source, what it is we want to import. Step number two, we choose our how we want to do it, right? Do we want to copy? Do we want to move? Do we want to add? Third thing, this is the most important. This is the destination. Where do you want the photos to actually go? Now, this comes down to personal preference. Some people like images to be on their internal. Some people like images to be on their external. Depends on what you're looking for. Personally, for me right now, I'm just gonna import images to the pictures folder on my internal hard drive. But I do wanna point out, I can click up here, I can go to other destination, and you can point Lightroom to import your pictures wherever you want them to go. So if you have an external hard drive plugged in, you can send them there, whatever you wanna do. I'm just gonna say, hey, let's send them to the pictures folder. You can even go to my user account and pictures, where is that? Right there, select, and there we are. So that's the third thing. Now, there are some other little settings down here on the right that I would set. I would build standard size previews. Previews make it so when you're going through your images really, really quickly in Lightroom, we've all probably experienced that where when we don't have previews, whenever you go to the next photo, it takes the computer a few seconds to produce a sharp image. Previews do that on import. So when you're going through your images and editing after the fact, you can go bam, 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 and Lightroom's like pa, 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 and it just loads the images instantly. It's magic, it's awesome. Render the previews at the beginning. Sweet. I don't rename my files. I don't apply anything during import. I try to keep that stuff pretty standard. The fourth thing though that's super important is how you want your images to be organized. Now, there's tons of schools of thought here, and a lot of people will disagree with me on what they think, what I think, whatever it happens to be. I organize things by date. I really like a dated organization system. That's only because I do my categorical organization with collections and keywords and metadata information, other organizational techniques in Lightroom. If I was one to just forget all that other stuff and not want to do collections, keywords, catalog, all that stuff, I would probably organize things by category. But for me, the folder structure organization by date makes the most sense. So I'm going to uncheck into subfolder here. You could check that. and make a subfolder called like My Photos, and it would put all the images into a subfolder. I'm gonna turn that off though, delete that out of there. All I wanna say is organize by date, and then I'm gonna choose this date format where it will make a year folder and then a year-month-day. One thing to point out that's important here, you'll notice that it picked today's date as the day. That is not where it's going to import the pictures to. The images themselves will be imported by the date that they were taken. So if they weren't taken today, it'll look at the metadata and put them in a folder associated with the date that you shot them, even if that was a week or a year, 12 years ago. Maybe not 12, that's a long time, but a lot of years ago. So I choose that, we choose our destination, we choose how we want the images to be imported, and we choose our source. The last thing I'll do is kind of do a quick scroll through. We have some images here that my wife Sarah took of a professional intensive photo shoot we did mountain biking. Really cool. We had an instructor named Michael Clark come in. He's a professional adventure photographer and he'd spent a whole week with the students. It was awesome. And Sarah was shooting candids here. And we can see the images. These haven't been imported yet. This is just a preview. And one thing I sometimes like to do is uncheck. You guys can see there's a little checkbox in the upper left of each photo. Uncheck images that are pretty clearly underexposed or overexposed or just not exciting, right? We can uncheck a few of these and that'll just save you time. Like there, someone's arm is in the way, right? We can just uncheck these images and that'll save some time when you're importing to only import the really good images. All right. So lastly, we would hit the import button just like that. That will import the photographs and you'll have images in your computer. Now to summarize, really important, when you're importing, you are not actually adding the images to that Lightroom catalog file. Just like we talked about earlier, it's two separate things. Photos and catalog are two separate entities. When this import is done, what's gonna happen is in my pictures folder, in my user account, or in your case, wherever your destination is set, in that folder, there will be all of the pictures on this memory card. Lightroom's gonna copy them to that location. You need to leave those pictures be. Don't touch them, don't reorganize them, don't do anything outside of Lightroom. Now in Lightroom, if you want a keyword collection, edit, reorganize, all that stuff, it's great because Lightroom will update the catalog and tell you that it did it. But you don't want to do anything outside of Lightroom because that's where missing images, exclamation points, question marks, all of those terrible things that a lot of you have probably experienced, that's where that comes from. So once images are imported into Lightroom, don't touch them outside of the program. I cannot say how important that is, all right? So four steps. What do you want to import? How do you want to do it? Where do you want them to go? And how do you want them organized? Hopefully this video shed a little bit of light on importing for you, whether you've been importing for a while or this is brand new. Hopefully you understand the process a little bit better. If you like this video, hit that thumbs up button. You disliked it, hit the dislike button. If you have a question or video idea or a comment or whatever it happens to be, leave that down in the comments box. And lastly, hit that subscribe button in the corner to stay up to date. Also, there's a little bell icon next to the subscribe button. If you hit that, YouTube will actually notify you when we post more videos. Thanks for watching.